Hello world, welcome to part 2 of my Christmas lights playlist. In this video we'll be connecting, or we'll be installing Xlights and connecting it to our HinksPixPro controller. If you're new to my channel, welcome to my channel where I'm using the Python programming language to build my own digital assistant named Shane, like Jarvis from the Iron Man movies and comics. Please consider subscribing if that interests you. So please make sure you've watched part 1 of this playlist. That way you can power on your HinksPixPro, get the IP address, and connect it to the internet. And because you'll need all of that to start with this. So like I said, make sure that your HinksPixPro controller is on, you're connected to the internet, and you have the IP address so you can continue along with this video. So the first thing we'll do is download Xlights by going to xlights.org/releases. Find whatever one applies to you. Mine was this Windows 64-bit. So you go ahead and download it and install it. And I put yes, please put desktop icons. So once that's done, you can read the instructions, but there's no... It's just a normal wizard that pops up. You'll have 3 desktop icons right here. Xlights 64, Xscanner 64, and Xschedule 64. Go ahead and open up the Xlights 64. And when I first downloaded it and installed it, it took quite a bit of time to open up. But now it opens up kind of quickly. Okay, so when it opens up, mine was already found, but if yours doesn't, you can go ahead and add a new one by clicking Add Ethernet. So you can see when I hover over it, it says use this button to add E131, which is what you want to do. And then you'll be given this one. So I named mine Hinks Pro. The description, I just named it my first controller. The vendor, you click HinksPix, Model Pro. If this isn't checkmark, make sure you checkmark your auto layout models, auto size. The rest of this, none of this, I didn't change any of this right here. This all came default, and that's all you need to do. And then go ahead, I'm going to leave my face here, and press save. And then you should have it like me right here. This Hinks Pro or whatever you named it, protocol is E131. So this is kind of your controller management screen here, right? So you can do controllers here. And one of the cool things is you can visualize it and it will show you all of the ports that you have. So if you remember from the first video, we had the DPI ports, 33, ignore this, I'll show you what that is in a second, 33 through 48, and that's shown here. So this is just a visual representation of all the ports you could possibly have. And we'll use this shortly. The other stuff we'll go over shortly, so the upload output and things like that. So the next screen is this layout screen, all right? And so yours will be empty right here. So the first thing I like to do is, since this is my first show, I like to visualize it. So if you go here, this background image, you can upload a picture of your house, right? Just any picture. I took a picture with my iPhone. And then you just upload it here. And I changed the width. I think I had to change the width to 1280, 720 in the brightness. Now, some people just take a picture at night, which makes sense, but I did not do that. And I left everything else the same. And then what you do is you just drag and drop all of these different options you have here. So you've seen the arches, I'm sure, in videos. You've seen candy canes. You've seen windows, circles, cubes. These are matrices, spheres, a mega tree. Oh, this is a window frame right here. So just all the things that you've seen common. So if you are with me in part one and you ordered a flood lamp or more than one, you're going to create this new single line and just press it like this right there. Like that. And so I am actually going to delete that. I don't want that. So I think I could just click it and press delete. Are you sure you want to delete it? Yep. But let's say you placed one here. Oops, I don't want all that either. So delete, yes, delete, yes. So I have one on here. I'm going to click off of that and click in here. And yours will look different. So if you just have a flood lamp, it's just one LED, right? It's one node, one string. If you have more than one flood lamp, which I'll show in a next video, you'll have more. But for now, we're just going to do one single line. So you're going to change that to string one. Node string is just going to be one. Lights, our node, is just going to be one. The starting location, this is kind of cool. You can make it a blue square, a green square. So if you have five of these, you can make the starting point be at the blue square or a green square, which would be over here. So that's kind of cool. But we're just going to leave ours with blue square for now. The controller, you connect to the only controller that I've showed. Leave that grayed out. Leave this the same. Preview the same. All of this. Now, when we get to port, if you remember from video one, we have our flood lamp connected to port 33. So you can change it here if you want. That's up to you. Or you can leave it blank and I can show you how to do it in another way. But I just clicked port 33. And then what you can do is you can go appearance here. So click active, but let's say you didn't want this anymore. You can click off of it and it goes away. You click it again, it's there. This pixel size, that's not a very big floodlight, right? It goes up pretty much. You can change this to 100. Save. And now that looks more like a flood lamp. You could place it right on here if you want. That's up to you. What most people do, I think, is this blended circle like that. To show. So I don't know why you'd want it square. But I'm fine with the smooth one. Then you can change the transparency, which is exactly what you think it is, like that. And that way it does look more like a flood lamp. Actually, I'm going to leave that because I like that. The size and location, if you wanted to manually move it versus clicking on it. So I'm going to save that. And that's how you install your first flood lamp. All right, so it shows it here. That's approximately where I'm going to put it. I don't know if I'm going to shine it directly on it. I don't know if I'm going to put it in the flower bed yet or not. We'll have to see. And I'll make a video because I'm going to bring you along through this whole thing. And then when we have another one, it's going to be facing here. And then another one's going to be facing my garage. All right, so that's the layout. Now from here, you can go to controllers. And then you can press upload output. And it might say not responding for a little bit. And that's okay. But it'll eventually say upload complete. And once you do that, you can go to your controller to check it. All right. So this is my IP address. And now you can go to port config, go to whatever expansion ports you place it on. If you're following along with me, it's in 33 through 48. And this was already changed in the previous video, but if this used to be 9600 for you to 9899, then now it should say controller start channel 1. it should say pixel count 1 and controller end channel 3. All right? And that means you successfully uploaded the output to your controller. Now your controller knows that you have one flood lamp that you're going to be controlling. All right? So now we can go to sequencer. And we can start a new one. So file, new sequence. We can go to animation, unless you already know what kind of music you want to place it on. Most people I see is 20 frames per second. You can do more options, or you can skip it. And then you can go to info media, depending on what you want. I'm going to do the sequence duration 60 seconds. And then I'm just going to press done in the wizard. So up here, you can see 0 through 1 second. If you have a song, then it would have uploaded the song as well. And now it should find all the different things you have connected to there. So if I go single line, and then strand 1, node 1, this is where I am programming right here my first sequence. Okay? So I'm going to actually load a sequence that I made. Let's go floodlight test, open, discard changes. And now let's look what I did. So single line, strand 1, node 1. And what I did was I brought in this bar chart right here. Oh, I'm sorry. Color wash. So before you drag and drop this color wash, what I did was I clicked on the buttons I want. So I unclicked this white. And then I clicked, so like this, red, green, blue. And then I dragged the bars over. Or I'm sorry, the color wash over. Like this. I just brought it over like that. And then now we can play what it looks like here. So it didn't make any moves, but you can kind of see what it did right here. For right now, don't click this button. Click here, play. And you can see in both this, just this view here, and in this view here, this house preview, what it's doing. So it's basically color washing every 30 seconds from this red color to blue. And then it will switch back to red at approximately, or at exactly 30 seconds. There we go. And that's what it does. And I just did that repeating, for 5 minutes, just for a test, right? This was only testing. All right. And so just know that all of these right here, I'm not going to go into all of them yet, but let's say you wanted to click a candle effect. The candle effect has several pixels and nodes. And if you drag this fire, this candle effect over, it's only going to be showing, your flood lamp is only going to be one of those pixels. So it's not going to have this cool candle, this reddish orange. It's probably just going to be the white blinking in different values because that's the first corner of the candle effect. Same thing if I brought in this tree or this lightning or laser or fireworks, it's only going to show one pixel. For it to show something bigger, you're going to need a string of lights or a candy cane or a mega tree. So I tried my testing with fire, this candle, and I tried it with this fire, and I was like, man, I suck at this. And I realized that I'm only controlling one pixel of something that requires, let's say, 50 pixels, like a strand of Christmas lights. So just be aware of that we're using the flood lamp, which is only one node, one pixel. When we have 5 of these together, or however many we plan to use, across my house, right here, then we can do different effects then, right? We can wash across from all of them, things of that nature. Now we'll have 5 pixels to mess with. So now anytime you make a change or do something, go ahead and press render all like that. Then it renders this sequence. And now I already showed you that you can play it in this viewpoint here. But let's actually check out how we can test it live when we have our flood lamp hooked up inside of our house. Or if we had our laptop outside and we were updating it live. So let me switch my camera around and show you how you use this right here, this output to lights. Okay, so I turn my camera to face my controller and my flood lamp. And this is inside my house, so I can record this video. And as you can see in my camera, it's very dark in here. And so let's say you have, I just put repeating color washes here, or I'm sorry, color washes here. And I just drag and dropped them, sized them to about 30 seconds each. And this was just for testing purposes. This is not what my show is going to look like. But so let's say you want to see how that looks, right? One option you can do is live testing, maybe in your workbench, or you can bring your laptop outside. And then you can just output directly to the lights by clicking this right here. All right, now you have to make sure your controller's done all the steps we talked about already. Controller, upload output, you check your HinksPix controller to make sure to upload it correctly. And then your sequence. So you can press this output to lights. Make sure you're at the beginning right here. And then just press play. And the... it will automatically start playing so you can do live testing, right? And so we'll just go through the first 30 seconds so you can see. It's going through green right now. And now it's going to fade into blue color right here, right? It's color washing, which means it goes from the lightest value to the darkest. And then it'll do a quick jump to red and start the process all over. And it just keeps on doing that. All right. And so that's how you do live testing. In the next video, we'll go over how to save this to a SD card, how to update your controller so that accepts SD cards, and then you don't have to be connected to the internet, and then you can just run your Christmas light show either on a repeatable loop or on every 15 minutes using the scheduler, which we'll go over, not in the next video, but in the video after that. So I hope you enjoyed this walkthrough, and I'm excited to show you. I have 3 of these flood lamps right now, so in the next couple of days, I will be programming it myself and doing some fanciness. I'm a beginner of this, so you're walking through this whole process with me exactly how a beginner would. So thanks for watching. Goodbye, world.